Hey everybody, I'd like to thank you for tuning into this week's show. As you can see, I'm with my good buddy Adam Burish again from the Dallas Stars, and we're going to be fishing some big largemouth bass today, Adam. We're on Lazy Lake and Fall River. You've seen me here before, folks, and the reason I come here, it's kind of a trophy lake. They got an 18-inch size limit, which means nobody comes here to catch fish to eat, basically. You come here to catch the biggest largemouth of your life. So hopefully, Adam, we'll get that for you today.
And, I hope so.
Stay tuned, folks. Me and Adam, we're going to be throwing a lot of topwater, scum frogs, and baits like that, bringing these big largemouth right out of the weeds and hopefully right into our boat. A few words from our sponsors. We'll be right back. Cool. Let's start fishing.
Hey folks, I'm Will Bradis and co-host of Fishing Wisconsin TV. When I'm not out catching fish with Bill Spahn, I'm selling real estate for Century 21. Whether you're looking right here in South Central Wisconsin, across state lines, or even across the country to buy, sell, or build, give me a call, I can help. I can be reached at 608-345-6090. My email is will@c21affiliated.com.
Hey everybody, for live entertainment and great hospitality, Lakeside Bar and Grill is the only place to come on Lake Wisconsin.
Hi, we're Mazinet Marina, 52 years on Lake Mendota, family owned and operated.
Right off M on Bluebill Park Drive South. Follow the signs. Hey folks, if you'd rather lead than follow, if you like having something that nobody else has, you need to get yourself a Gator jet boat. I fish out of a Luma Gator made by Gator Boats, and I guarantee you, a lot of the fish I catch have never seen another boat. And my Gator boat has never let me down. Give my good friend Randy at Gator Boats a call, and you will not be sorry you did. I can promise you that. Ooh, does he got it?
Yep.
No, he's got it. Good job, Adam.
Yeah, that one, I just waited a second longer
before
I cranked on it.
He just grabbed it. Did he grab it twice or just?
No, I think I just kind of waited until I felt the weight.
Oh, there you go. Yep. Cool. Not a 5-pounder, but a start.
He's in here.
He's in the boat. So you get your meat and you get your lettuce too with this when you fish Lazy Lake.
Yeah.
And you got two hooks on that guy to worry about. He kind of chased her down, didn't he?
Yeah. Yeah, the first one I missed. Right when I saw him jump at it, I cranked it.
Yeah.
And I missed him. This one I waited a second longer, like you said. I felt the weight and then... Yeah, I ripped at it.
Because they usually won't let go of it, you know. They grab it, and they think it's a meal, so they don't let go right away. So, yeah, you just wait and feel them, and good job.
All right, well, there's a start.
They'll get bigger. Cool. Good job.
Good coaching.
There you go.
When it hit the water at him, oh, it feels like a good fish, man. But you know what? I threw out, and I looked around, and I heard a slurp, and I looked back, and I didn't see my frog. It's like, oh, they're starting to pick up.
Yeah.
They're not getting too much bigger, but they're starting to pick up. Well, this isn't too bad a fish. Oh, geez, it's bigger than I thought. Oh, it's a nice one.
Nice.
Not too bad. Look at that, Adam. Holy smokes. I got a lot of vegetables with it again. Look at how he engulfed that bait, Adam. He just ate it. Check that out. That's a healthier fish than I thought.
Yeah, that's a nice one. They're getting hungry.
Yeah, and they're just gobbling up. But isn't that just the prettiest
largemouth?
I mean, look at the colors.
They're gorgeous. Look at how he ate that bait too. Just
swallowed it.
Go. They can chomp. Awesome. Well, we're all tied up there. Not that I'd keep track.
Cool. Well, things are getting better.
Yeah.
Gorgeous. I'd say that's about a. It's about an 18 incher. I mean, that's nice. Fat bass, nice and healthy in this lake. No parasites on them. Got to kiss the first one. See ya. Go get your grandma. Go get granny.
Oh. I'll catch her.
Luke, I hope you do. Wow, that was sweet.
That was awesome.
Sweet. I love it. Alrighty. I was just going to switch baits too. You know, I was just going to switch. Another one?
Another one.
Bring him in.
Yeah.
Oh, is that a good fish, I think, Adam?
Another one jumping right next to mine, too.
Or he's moving a lot of water. He's moving a lot of water.
This is bigger than the last one.
Looks like he's moving water, but keep him coming. That's the one thing about this, if you give him any. Ooh, nice tail. That's how you judge how big they are. It's like from their dorsal to their tail, or their tail, because you can't really tell. But if you stop reeling there, then you can reach down and kind of get that junk off him before you lift him in, because there's always, oh, there's his mouth. I see his mouth. Yeah, don't worry about getting junk in the boat. We'll clean her up nice. Oh, nice fish, Adam. I got a needle nose too if you need. Oh, he's getting big. That's nice.
That's bigger than the last one.
Right off. Check that out. That's a gorgeous fish. That's about the size of one I just
got. Yeah, same one. They're getting bigger.
That nice. Cool. Wow, good job, bud. Knuckles on that one.
Nice.
Good job. Adam, there's one thing I always wanted to know, and I never knew, even playing goalie when I was growing up. But I know like a professional baseball player can throw a fastball, what, 96, 98?
Yeah.
How fast, do you have any idea, can somebody with a slap shot make a puck go? How fast?
Right around 100 miles an hour they're going.
Really? They're going
when guys are hitting them. Most guys are hitting them right between 90 and 100 miles an hour is what they're usually going at. I think the hardest, last year the guy that got clocked the hardest was I think 105 or 106 miles an hour.
Huh, wow.
He was shooting a solid rubber plastic puck, so you're crazy for ever being a goalie.
Oh, well.
Yeah, guys can hit it pretty hard. Then when they take a wrist shot, it's probably 70, 80 miles an hour, but then when they lean into one and take a slapper, it's 105 miles an hour of rubber, solid rubber coming right at your shoulder, right at your head. So.
And they freeze the pucks, don't they?
They freeze them before a game, so they don't bounce on the ice, and then they slide better, and they shoot harder.
Yeah, I wouldn't want to get
that's why they always say you goalies are the weirdos.
Yeah, I know. It sure was fun, though. I loved it. Yeah. And see how he followed me out?
Yeah.
Ooh, it's a big fish, too, Adam.
It is a nice one.
This guy just followed me out. Like I was just talking about the edge. You know, right at the edge, these fish will roam. Oh, come here, baby.
Mm, nice one.
Good catch, huh?
Yeah.
Brought back my goalie days of catching pucks out of there. But that's about the size of the last two we got. Just nice, big, fat fish. You know, a regular lake, this would be a hog. It'd be like, look at the size of this. But in this lake, it's just kind of an average fish.
Yeah.
That's why Lazy Lake, Fall River folks, I'm telling you, can really catch a lot of nice, big fish. Hey, everybody, stay tuned. Next week's show, Adam and I, we're going to be catching some incredibly nice smallmouth bass on the Wisconsin River. You don't want to miss that one. I think Adam actually outfishes me that day.
I doubt it.
Now the sun's not quite where we wanted, but yeah, Adam, he's pushing 18,
yeah.
3 pounds. In a tournament, he'd like a bunch of those. See ya, buddy. What, did he take off fast, didn't he?
Yeah.
He was back in those thick weeds fast, folks. That's the ticket, though. These weeds hold the big fish. So you're either fishing in them or just on the outside of them. And that'll usually do the trick. Cool, we might be honest.
Back in the game.
Yep. Had to change up. Whatever, funny. You know, I was just looking at that path, and I wasn't even thinking about my bait, and all of a sudden it just went, boop, kind of like a bobber, just straight down. Just a little guy. But another little bass, largemouth. They sure are pretty, though, aren't they?
Yeah.
I love them. They're so deep green, the color of them. You know, isn't that a pretty little fish? And they do look nice and healthy in this lake.
Yeah, they look nice.
He's just a little feller. We'll get him on.
That one was just off the weed line too, huh?
Yeah, and my bait was just sitting still, you know, and he just kind of plopped it down. Cute little guy. He gets a little blink. Awesome.
Cool.
Yep. But yeah, I wonder what that.
Maybe it's the time of the day. They're turning on a little bit, maybe.
Yeah, well, it's getting there. They should. I mean, before dark is always a good time. You know, it was funny. Oh, but he was almost in the same spot as the last one, Adam.
Same exact spot.
I just let it set, you know. Folks, it's so funny, you know, you always can figure out a pattern. And this has been kind of a tough day. We've caught fish, but what I think it is, we've just got to let our bait sit. And they're looking at it, and finally it just gets them aggravated enough where they come up and eat it. There we go. There we go. Get the hook out quick. They're really, when they are eating it, though, they're eating it up, Adam. I mean, they inhaled it. Little tiny guy. He's healthy looking, but little. Go grow up, buddy. Boom. Well, Adam, we didn't exactly tear him up today, but at least I introduced you to a different way of fishing, really. This topwater stuff is kind of fun sometimes.
Yeah, it was cool.
Yeah, you know, when you get a lot of weeds and stuff, you know, they call it slopping. And as you can see, the boat is full of slop. It was fun, but hey, I appreciate you jumping in the boat with me again. And hey, folks, make sure you check out Adam Burish with the Dallas Stars this year. I think you'll have a lot of fun watching. I know I do. And thanks for fishing with me again, Adam. And we'll see you next week. And you folks, we'll see you next time.
Oh, it's a hog. Look at this. I'm going to come down here to get him. I got a good one. Oh, baby. Stay on there. Oh, baby. Stay on there.
If your vehicle has been damaged in an accident, there's only one place to call. That's Poinette Auto Body. Luke and his entire staff will take care of all your auto body needs. Luke and his entire staff, they kept me informed. They used the latest technology. They took care of my claim, and they made sure the whole process went smoothly. So if you're in need of auto body repair, or if you simply just need to replace a vehicle, my friends at Poinette Auto Body and Sales will take care of all your auto body needs.
The death of a pet is never easy for pet parents, but comforting surroundings and the attention to your needs is important to Midwest Cremation Service. Whether you choose to be a part of the process or not, Midwest Cremation Service is there for you during this time of loss.
To let you know how much your kind words and your understanding meant to me. You helped me find some peace in the passing of my special friend.
When unconditional love deserves uncompromised care, contact us at Midwest Cremation Service.
As a single mother of two children with autism, I understand the challenges, the heartaches, and the expense in obtaining proper therapy equipment. That is why I started Affordable Therapy Solutions. Give you all the tools you need at a low, affordable cost.
Amanda and her staff at Affordable Therapy Solutions come through for us every time.
Visit affordabletherapysolutions.com and discover all the wonderful treatment options for your loved ones.
Hey everybody, for live entertainment and great hospitality, Lakeside Bar and Grill is the only place to come on Lake Wisconsin. Hey everybody, in this segment I'm going to teach you the fine art of fishing a break line. And what that is, it's in a river system where the current comes down and it runs right along parallel where there's no current at all. And you'll find this right where there's an eddy. So what I'm going to use, it's called a fluke. It looks like a French fry. And what I like to do right now, the bass, it's the end of August, they're not touching buzz baits. They'll come up and look at them, but they just won't slam them. They won't take them. So I'm going to float this right down along that edge and see if we can get some nice smallies to pick this little guy up. Usually they're nice and big, but take a look, folks, out there. You'll see the rocks there on the shoreline, and you'll see behind me, you can see where the current is, and then you'll see the slack water. My object is to get this right on that point, right where the current is and the slack water. So it'll drift right above their heads, and it's usually a little deeper right there. And let's just see what happens here. There we are. Now what I've done, as you can see, guys, I took the boat and I brought it right up on shore. I put down my trolling motor. So I basically pegged myself right here on shore. That's why I took my vest off, because I'm only in 6 inches of water. But I just let that bait float on down and I keep my rod tip up. So if I feel that tick, 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 tighten up my line and set the hook. Another thing I'd like to tell you, you know, as soon as I take a hook out of the package, like this True Turn hook, as soon as I take it out of the package, the first thing I do is sharpen it. And people say, what are you, nuts? It's brand new. But you know what? The cartilage of a smallmouth's mouth, a big smallmouth is tough. And as you've seen on my show, sometimes it looks like I have trouble getting the hooks out of the mouths of the bass I catch. The reason is because the penetration of those hooks are so deep. But that hook, I took it out. First thing I did was sharpen up the edge of it, made it razor sharp. I don't want to lose any big fish. It's hard enough getting big fish on. I'm not going to lose them. It's floating down. I don't feel anything at all. So it's floating over the heads. Oh, right there. Oh, see my rod tip right there, folks? Think I got one on there. I'm going to feel him. Oh, there we go. There's a fish on right there. See how that worked? Feels like a good fish. Can't really tell. You know, the water's 83 degrees right now. Oh, he's coming in real easy. Oh, there you go. Oh, now he's in the, just got in the current, I think. I can't tell. Oh, this is a big fish. This is a good fish, I think. Oh, I think he's wrapped around my boat. Oh, it's a hog. Look at this. I'm going to come down here to get him. I got a good one. Whoa, baby. Stay on there. Oh, baby, stay on there. Look at my little French fry thing up there. Oh, look at that hook set right on the top. Perfect. All the way through the mouth. Check this out, folks. Stay there, baby. Oh, don't get off. Don't get off. Right on top. Hooked him good. Went all the way through. Wow, what a sweet fish. Come on, baby. There we go. Nice sharp hook. Hey, folks, paying attention to detail. We'll get a few of these in your boat. Let's get that big boy back in the water. Now, this is the best part of fishing for me. Here you go, big guy. Are you ready? See ya. Let's get another one. That was fun. All right. Get my wacky worm set back up. Woo, that took my breath away. That was a good fish. All right, everybody. I got my bait out there far enough in the current. And the current's taken, as you can see right now. And I'm just feeding it out. Current's really strong out there. Okay, whoop, right there, I felt a tick. I felt another tick. This could be another fish, I don't know. It's really hard to tell. I'm way out there. It's either a tick or a log. Oh, I think it's a fish. Oh, it's a fish, look it out there. Just look out in the water, folks. It's another hog. He came right up. I think he's gonna come up again. Take a look at this boy. Right here, right in the back of the boat. Look at right in the back of the boat. Oh, it's a nice fish too. It's another 18 or 19 inch smallie. Oh, I can't even believe this. We're 1 mile south of the Dells. Look at that. I'm gonna have to go down and lip him again. Look at that. Oh, baby. I can't believe it. That was within 15 minutes of each other. Two fish this big within 15 minutes. Stay there, baby. Stay there, baby. That's 4 pound smallmouth, folks. Stay there. Please open your mouth. Open your mouth. Open your mouth. Open your mouth. Oh, they're so strong when they're that big. Woo! Woo! Oh, what a belly on that baby. Late August. That's a 20-inch smallmouth, folks. That's over 4 pounds, I guarantee. I can barely hold them up. And again, oh, look at that. My hook that time fell right out. I'm lucky I got that big one to the boat. Look at the size of that beautiful smallmouth bass. Boy, that's a hog. I'm going to let him go. Woo! There's nothing more fun. I lost my goofy French fry thing on that one. Hey there, big boy. In this warm weather, folks, sometimes you got to hold these fish. It's 83 degree water temp, and it takes them a little bit to recoup. There he goes. He bit my finger. He's like, I want out of here, Bill. Woo, I'm gonna get me another bait, and we're doing it again. All right, folks, this is a hunk of plastic, but it's called a Senko. A lot of bass fishermen use these baits. And because of what I'm doing today, floating it down above the heads of these big smallies, I'm gonna hook it the same way, called wacky style. Look at that. Can you imagine a fish eating it? It smells like grape bubble gum. Let's give it a whirl. Let's see what happens. We just got those two beauties. Let's see if we get one more. That is fun. Well, I'm dry. I gotta get a beverage. Oh, what the? Hold on. Never fails, folks. I'm going to get a can of pop. Oh, sure enough. Another one. He's up on top already. He wasn't very deep at all. He wasn't even in the current. He was off the current. He's coming around. I think he's going around the back of the boat. He is, son of a gun. Well, come on, big fella. He's not as big as the others, but he's not bad. Oh, come here, buddy. Come on, buddy. Don't get in my motor. Where is he? I don't know where he is. Do you see him back there? There he is. Whew. Another quality fish on a different type of bait, but still the same principle. Just floating it down the current break. Take a look at this one. Another 18. Nice fish. Open up, buddy. Oh, there we go. Oh, baby. Whew. Wisconsin River smallies, folks. I can guarantee you, if you don't get out here and try this, we put in off of 16 off of highway. Oh, it's tough boat ramp. You got to have four-wheel drive to get in and out. And then we just drove up the river a little tiny ways. I got to get this hook out. That true turn went all the way through the gristle. There we go. Unhooked. But look at that. That's 18. 18 and a half. They've all been huge fish. And just that quick, I've been here, folks. I parked my boat here. I bet I've been here for an hour. Probably an hour. And I've got these three buttes. River smallmouth bass. I tell you. This is all I catch today. It was a fantastic day. Hey, everybody. Bill Spahn with Fishing Wisconsin TV. Keeping it real on the Wisconsin River. We'll see you next week. Got to give that one a kiss. Go home, baby. We'll see you next year. What do you say? Oh, it's sitting right there. Will and I, we're fishing the Wisconsin River, and we're going to be fishing some river muskies today. And if you saw an episode last year, I was with Adam Burish. We were fishing some muskies, and Adam got about a 50-incher on. We got it right next to the boat, and it didn't fit in the net. But take a look at this bad boy. This is Grandpa Hank's ocean net. Today, if we get that 50-incher on, I guarantee you, Will, he's going in the net.
Yeah, he'll probably fit.
Stay tuned, folks. Hopefully, Will and I will get a couple big river muskies on today's show. Smallie, yeah. That smallie liked that shade, didn't he? Well, those muskies got to eat something for lunch, everybody. Woo, that's a fatty. He's a fatty. He's a fatty. On the buzzer.
On the buzzer.
What do you think, 18?
I'll bump mine. Seven.
Oh, nice fat fish.
Good start today. Set it downsize.
You're catching the muskie's lunch. Yeah, that's nice.
Nice looking fish.
Yep, nice river smallmouth bias. That didn't take long. I didn't even start my crank wheel. Literally, he ate it when it hit the water. I mean, yeah, this was the strangest. It's a smallie, I'm sure. But it's a big smallie. But you know what? It was the funniest thing. I threw my bait and I was just gonna give it a crank. And something's running with my bait. Look at that. Isn't that strange? I got a lot of wood coming up. I'm going to let you grab this guy, Will.
Yeah.
I'm going to hoist him. Here you go. Oh, God, he's a big one. But now I got to get on the trailer motor. Yeah, Will, that fish hit before my spinner bait even had one turn in it. So put him on the board. Let's just see how big he is. I bet he's 18, maybe 18 and a half.
He's a good fish, Bill.
It's big.
Whew. And 5/8.
Wow, almost a 19-inch smallmouth bass. Out here fishing for muskies, folks. I love it.
That's a dandy.
I love it. That's muskie food. Nice. Good job, Will. Oh, isn't that pretty? Swimming away like that. Knuckles on that. They're not on top of the sandbar. These guys are on top. Yeah, they're on top of the sandbar. Yeah, it's the weirdest thing. Is it a smallie or a striper?
I think it's a smallie.
Oh, I just had one smack mine, folks. Now, is it a striper or a striper, I bet you? No, it is a smallie. So we got a big school of smallies on top of a sandbar. I tell you, folks, it's good to have a camera person that's really looking around, because our camera person noticed these fish busting over here. We came over here and fished the side of the sandbar, but we found out Will threw them way up on top, and they're on top of the sandbar. Same spot, Will, huh? See, that's a great example about leaving some water alone and then coming back, Will. You know, we left it alone for 45 minutes, came back, and they're still here. Or they came back. We spooked the school off of here. Oh, yeah. Yep, they're really hanging on this this point. Downriver Point. Yeah, what a spot. What a spot. Yep, good spot. Nice little area. You know, Will, do you remember? I was throwing my buzzbait and I made a really long cast up near shore. And usually a buzzbait, folks, you know, the fish hits it when it's coming back because it's making a chirping noise and turning up the water. Literally, I didn't even close my bail, and you and me both saw my line going down river. Bam!
Almost
and
then I like saw, you landed on his bottom lip.
It had to almost hit that fish in the head, and he just grabbed it and started swimming, and I set the hook, and that was a 18 and 5/8.
18 and 5/8. I know just, for sure that that prop never turned our direction. I think it was still spinning backwards when it landed. Bam.
You know, just a dandy fish. You know, and every time out, it seems like something happens that's new. That's what I love about fishing so much. Something new and exciting every time you go out or you learn something new. Seems like every time you go out. And the pattern we put together today with the smallies guys was they were in the shade real close to shore, weren't they? Most of them.
The bigger fish that we caught tended to be in the shade on the edges.
Yep.
But we had, can't deny the action out there on the top of that sand.
And the reason why is because all those minnows were up on top.
Yeah.
And the smallies would go up there and chase them. Because we went into that little slough, and I noticed all these minnows in about 5 inches of water. That's the minnows, for some reason, come up there. I think those microorganisms are hatching out of the sand or something. The minnows are up there eating them, and, well, of course, the smallmouth are soon to follow.
That made a lot of sense. There's deep water nearby.
Yeah.
I think it makes for an easy meal for a smallmouth. They tend to work in packs. A few of them get together, herd them minnows.
Definitely.
Bam,
yep.
Bam,
ball
bam.
Them up. Hey, everybody, thanks for tuning in to this week's show. Will and I will definitely be back this summer with these big baits to give those muskies another try, but what another fun and exciting day out on the Wisconsin River, huh, Will?
You got that right. The fish at 10,000 casts. We probably got halfway there today.
Yeah, no kidding. My arms are killing me. But hey, everybody, Will and Bill keeping it real on the Wisconsin River. We'll see you guys next week.